Hello and welcome to Projector, and on this episode, Amy Adams and Jeremy Renner face the arrival of aliens. When 12 sets of spaceships appear in sights scattered across the globe, linguist Louise Banks, played by Amy Adams, is brought in by Colonel Webber, played by Forrest Whitaker, to help decode their language. She, alongside theoretical scientist Ian Donnelly, played by Jeremy Renner, are taken to one of the ships, based in Montana, to establish first contact and work out what exactly their intentions are. But as an increasingly scared and divided world grows concerned the aliens' purpose may be hostile, Louise must figure out the truth before misinterpretation brings the world to war. Arrival is the new film from acclaimed Canadian director Denis Villeneuve, based off the 1998 short story by Ted Chiang, Story of Your Life. And in the last couple of years, Villeneuve has quickly gained recognition as being one of the best directors working today. And he's especially made his mark with mainstream audiences with his English language thrillers, Enemy, Sicario and Prisoners, all which are beautiful, intricately designed movies, but incredibly brutal and intense. And with Arrival, he's crafted a movie that's no less suspenseful, but significantly less violent, focusing more on the theme of language and communication. And Villeneuve is apparently quite a fan of sci-fi and fantasy. He's actually wanted to do this movie for quite some time. This is a bit of a pet project for him. Ironically, he's now working on his second sci-fi movie now, the sequel to Blade Runner with Ryan Gosling. And in terms of alien movies, it's more of a rebuttal to things like Independence Day. It's far closer to movies like Interstellar or The Day the Earth Stood Still than Blasting Aliens. If you're going into this movie expecting action and spectacle, you might come away a little bit disappointed because that's not what the film is about. That's not what the film is intending to be. However, you should still go and see this movie because it is fantastic. This is a movie that shows Villeneuve at the top of his directing powers, and you can see that especially in the sequence where they visit the spaceship for the very first time. And there's this real sense of wonder and presence to it. You feel the weight of this monumental event on screen, and it feels like Villeneuve has worked everything down to the most minuscule of details, even right down to something like the texture that Renner's character feels on the underside of the craft. And that's something that makes it feel like an actual tangible object on screen. It doesn't feel like an empty special effect. It gives it a human touch. And there is something genuinely impressive about it. But the craft, there's also something very intimidating and ominous about it. And that ambiguity is placed in that design deliberately, because it does look so unusual. The texture of it, especially on the inside, in this narrow shaft where the gravity pivots halfway up it, it does suggest an advanced race, but there is something about it that's a little bit cold, this black, rock-like texture that actually reminded me a little bit of Ridley Scott's Prometheus, the spaceship in that. And some people might call the actual pacing of the movie a little bit slow. They would be wrong. The pacing is deliberate. There is never a point in this movie where I felt like it was dragging in any way. It feels like it's just paced perfectly right. You're always waiting for the next reveal. You're always waiting for the next bit of information to come. There is this drip feed throughout the movie, and Villeneuve knows how to just draw things out for the right amount of time, and you are just fully in his grip. And he does this not only to give that sense of wonder that I mentioned, but also to build the suspense and atmosphere. I should also mention Johan Johansson's fantastic score, which is a big part of that. In that sequence, it very much puts you on the same page as Amy Adams' Louise, who is feeling a little bit feverish, very nervous. She doesn't know what to expect, and neither do we, because we haven't met the aliens in this sequence. We don't know what their intentions are or even what they look like. So we have no idea what's going to happen, and there's this real sense of tension and, you know, palpable nervousness. You can feel it in your stomach. And it's just so engaging as a piece of cinema. It's just breathtaking. I should mention that I'm actually being very cautious about what I mention in this review, because this is a film that's best served cold. You need to go into it knowing fairly little about it, because the real pleasure of it and the way that it works most effectively is if you don't know what's going to happen. If you're on this, it is a movie about discovery, so it makes sense that you're on the same page as Adams and Renner in the movie. You need to be on that page for it to work as effectively as it should do. But what really impressed me is how well Villeneuve threads this theme of communication and language throughout the entirety of the movie, and it reverberates throughout it, sometimes in ways that are quite subtle and sometimes in ways that are quite obvious, like the fact that the main conflict of the movie is trying to work out what exactly the aliens are saying and then trying to work out what their intentions are. That is the main focus of the movie, and it's a film that's very much based in intellectualism. It's very much about linguistics, and you would think that would be something that would be a little bit dry and dull as a subject, but honestly it's not. They find a way of making it fascinating. There is something really quite interesting about this hypothetical what-if scenario of aliens landing. How do you communicate with a completely different species that has developed their own language based around different circles, for example? How do you try and decode that into a common language? I mentioned that it has more in common with, you know, hard sci-fi movies, and the point of comparison that's especially the most obvious and actually the one that's probably best is Robert Zemeckis' Contact, which was very much about the same thing, except it was more focused on mathematics. The movie actually gets a little bit of a shot at that sort of theory, in that Jeremy Renner's character is a theoretical scientist who specialises in mathematics. He's trying to use Fibonacci and other such things, but of course, even if they did try and throw equations at them, since they don't know what the aliens are saying, they don't know whether they actually recognise them or not. I thought that was a little bit amusing. Even with that said, there is something really quite engaging about seeing this gradual progression throughout the movie of them trying to just work out what exactly each side is saying. But what really isn't helping is the fact that we as a world, we're not all united. And I don't mean that in terms of politics or ideology, but simply in terms of language. We all speak in various different tongues. And that proves to be especially difficult because, of course, the shuttles have all landed in 12 different sites across the globe, and each of these countries are having to work together, but it's under this very terse relationship. None of them really wants to diverge what the others know. That relationship is so fragile that it could disintegrate at any particular moment. Although we're afraid of aliens, there is this hostility and suspicion amongst us that does threaten us in some way. It is one of our worst features. And it's something that is especially clear because some countries like China and Russia, they take the approach that the aliens are going to attack. They're very much more of the confrontational countries. But they're all having to be relayed to each other through little screens. They're all in little chat windows, and so we're using a form of communication to talk to each of these countries, and it's very much a point in the movie that technology features very prominently. You have in the tents near the spaceship, All these different interpreters on different screens watching through footage and conversing with other countries. And there's this idea that we're very much separate. It feels intentionally so that America is isolated from all these other sites. This idea of technology is something that keeps coming in time and time again, even as something as early as when the aliens first arrive and she goes into class and they keep getting interrupted by notifications on their phones and on their laptops. It seems like we're in a little bit of a communication overload. It seems to be what Villeneuve is trying to say. And the movie's most perceptive when it comes to the language of fear. And especially in regards to news media, it feels like Villeneuve is taking a very pointed look at that, because so much of what's happening on a global scale is conveyed through news reports. And you get the sense that the world is falling apart. There is mass hysteria and rioting going on. It feels like everything is going to hell in a handcart. And there is so much negativity going on here. And any time information from the spaceship leaks out to the media, they always spin it in the worst possible way. And it's always to try and stoke up tension. And it feels like Villeneuve is being especially critical of that sort of thing. It's not exactly an accident that Louise, earlier on in the movie, has to tell her mother over the phone, another bit of communication, that she shouldn't be watching that news channel. They don't know what they're talking about. They don't explicitly mention what that channel might be, but take a wild guess. And this idea of the internet and this sort of hate chamber that builds up around these sort of news reports, again, it's shown to have a damaging effect. It's shown that it actually impedes progress. And at a time like right now, that feels like a message that needs to be especially heard. And when I talk about language, I'm not simply referring to words or their definitions, but this much larger concept of meaning. You know, something as big as the language of life. How we define our experiences and ascribe our worldviews to them. You know, we're not all speaking the same language because we all live different lives. We've all had different experiences within it. And that's a big concept to wrap your head around. It's this very thought-provoking idea. And it's something that will resonate with you long after the movie is over. It's certainly something that I'd never thought about in quite that way before. And it's genuinely impressive. Villeneuve tackles this idea with surprising confidence. The film is very much based around this idea that certain events in our lives change them irrevocably. We define ourselves around those moments. And this is especially poignant when it comes to addressing ideas of grief and loss and how those are defined by those experiences. And there's something genuinely moving about them, even if the movie maybe gets a tiny bit too sentimental in its final third. But even still, there is such substance and weight to these ideas, and such complexity to them as well, that really grounds this adventure in something that's incredibly human. This is a movie that on its surface is about aliens and first contact played out on this global scale, but at its heart, it's a much smaller human story. And going even further on this idea of communication and meaning, it feels like Villeneuve is actually commenting on the medium of cinema itself, because the chamber that Louise meets with the aliens with, they're separated by this white barrier that looks like a screen. It looks like the 2:35 aspect ratio of the film itself. That can't be simply a coincidence. They look like shadows on the wall. It feels very much like Louise is in some ways the audience interpreting what she sees on the screen, essentially, like we are. It's actually very meta in some respects. And it's a nod to the fact that cinema itself has its own language that's developed over 100 years of edits and cuts and transitions and juxtapositions and framing. You know, all these things of mise-en-scene, essentially. The movie's got a fantastic cast, including fine support from the likes of Forrest Whitaker, who is fairly solid in an expositional role, and Jeremy Renner, who I did feel was a little bit underutilised here. He mostly serves as the comic relief and as a foil for Louise, offering her support on a journey, but it's not his movie. It's Amy Adams. She is the defining figure in this film. She is right at the centre of it, and she is brilliant. This is a movie that very much stands on her shoulders. She is in virtually every single scene of it, and she is so impressive here. This is easily some of the best work she's ever done on screen. She gives a real warmth to her role and compassion. and patience and intelligence and all these wide ranges of emotions. It's a very complex, nuanced performance that just aids the film immensely. I think it's a performance that's definitely going to get recognised because it shows just how wonderful a performer she is. She's given so many great performances that this stands out as a major accomplishment really says something. I think this could easily be a contender at the Oscars this time next year, in fact. And as I think about it more and more, especially in what's transpired in only the last couple of days since I've seen it, the movie just keeps going up in my estimation. This is a fantastic piece of cinema. It's not only a great piece of entertainment, but it's just brilliant on a storytelling level. It's intelligent, it's astute, it's a really timely piece of sci-fi that I would actually say is important in this day and age, and it's a really hopeful piece of work. It's something that I think we all need right now, this just wonderful piece of science fiction. It's easily one of the best examples of the genre in recent mainstream cinema, and one of the year's very best films. Go out and see it, you will not regret it. Arrival is a thoughtful and heartfelt look at what first contact may be like in a science fiction film that favours intelligence over spectacle and action. It shows director Denis Villeneuve at the top of his game, creating a dreamlike beauty to the film, while also mine the situation for the most amount of tension and drama. He also keenly reiterates the key theme of communication in numerous different ways and forms across its running time in a way that's never dry. Although Renner and Whitaker provide solid support, this belongs to Amy Adams, giving a sensitive performance as the film delves into loss and grief and their meaning. It's a heady and cerebral movie that's full of big ideas and keeps you enthralled the more it unfolds. Coming up soon, Amy Adams is back again as a nocturnal animal. We meet a different kind of animal in a street cat named Bob, while I, Daniel Blake, fights for his self-respect. But until then, I'm Matthew Buck, fading out.